Hi, everybody, and welcome back to this week's edition of the New Variety Art Show here on your public access station. We're glad you're tuned in. Call the neighbors, get the kids out of bed. It's going to be a good show today, and we're glad you're here. You know, the New Variety Art Show is all about variety arts in the 90s. That's clowns, mimes, jugglers, magicians, hypnotists, caricaturists, jugglers. Oh, speaking of jugglers, if you were here last week, it was an absolute madhouse. What a bunch of crazy guys, but we're glad they were here, and we had a lot of fun doing that. We are seen on several different public access stations here in the Valley, so check your local listings. And we hope that you'll make it a habit to tune in every week. Right now, I want you to say hello to our musical director, Van Coriton. Hi,
hello,
Van.
Brad.
Thanks for coming back again.
Good to be back after that mayhem.
I wasn't sure after last week if you'd brave it to come back or not.
Can't wait to see what we're going to do this week.
Yeah, we made it through the holidays here a little bit, and you know, there's another one coming up now.
It's already?
It's Valentine's Day very, very soon.
Oh.
Have you? I understand you recently got married. Is that
right? Less than a month ago.
Oh, goodness, you're still a newlywed. Well, right. You can't possibly forget Valentine's Day.
No.
Those are the things they never forget, you know. So have you picked out what you're going to get your better
half? No, I hoped you had some ideas.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know. Maybe our guest today will have a good idea or two.
I need some magic.
You need some magic?
Yeah.
Don't we all? Well, listen, our guest today is a friend of yours, I know.
Right.
And he is a violinist. I think that's what we call him.
Yeah.
And,
he's a fiddle player. I don't know.
Well, we'll find out for sure. His name is Steve Vaughn. And if you'll follow me, we're going to go over and meet Steve Vaughn, violinist. All right. Steve, thanks for being with us
Brad,
today.
Pleased to be here.
I'm glad you could take time out of your busy schedule to be with us today.
By all means.
I want to make sure. We weren't sure. Now, is it violinist or is it fiddler?
Actually, what that is, we're defining or differentiating between styles.
Ah.
Now,
okay.
Today I have my tuxedo on.
Uh-huh. Very snappy.
And I'm going to play the violin.
Uh-huh.
Now, okay. I could put on a pair of boots and some Levi's and go down to Handlebars J's, and I'd be playing a fiddle.
Ah, okay.
So it's kind of a...
That's the difference.
What you play defines what the instrument is.
Do you play both styles of music? Is that...
I can, yes. Yes, I do throw in some fiddle music and hoedowns in my presentations.
Do you have a preference?
I'm actually stronger, I think, in the classics, in the standard repertoire than the fiddle music.
Uh-huh.
Although I enjoy fiddle music, and I appreciate the people that can do that. It's a great act.
Yeah, I had an opportunity to host a show on another public access show called Fiddling Around, and we had some state champion fiddlers, and
okay.
They were real. You know, I mean, honest to goodness, fiddlers,
oh,
that's
yeah.
what they do, and they were incredible. It was a lot of fun to have them, and of course we have a lot of that kind of music available
Fine
here
musicians.
In the Valley. That's what I like about Phoenix, is we are culturally diverse here.
Yes,
in that you can go see fiddle music and hoedown and country western music, and you can go to the Phoenix Symphony and see symphonic music played mm-hmm. on violins and that sort of
That's
thing.
Right.
And you play a lot around town, I know. Where are some of the places that you play?
Well, I play in many different settings and situations. I do a lot of convention work. I have a little company called Starlight Strings, for example. And we book and market string music to the convention industry and the local market. And, for example, in the conventions, we might have a little string quartet playing during dinner for an awards banquet for an insurance company.
I see. Now, do you walk around the crowd, around the room? Is that the kind of thing?
I could be strolling. We have two acts. We have strolling acts, and we have your stationary sit-down ensemble.
I see.
Where you sit and read music.
Uh-huh.
So we can do that. Or on a weekend, a Saturday afternoon, you might find me at Brophy Chapel playing a ceremony.
Uh-huh. Like a wedding or something
right.
like that.
Yeah.
Very good. So you not only play by yourself then, but you also have other string instrument
right.
players that you work with.
Yes, I have an organization of people I've worked with for... Since school.
Yeah, violins, other violins.
Oh, cellos.
Cellos, yeah. Violas.
Exactly.
What's the other one? The bass?
The big one.
The granddaddy of them
right.
all. Aren't you glad you didn't take up the
yeah,
bass?
Yeah, it's hard to get under your chin. You know, it's really it's a trick.
I can imagine. Where are you from originally, Steve? Where do you call home?
I'm originally from Minnesota.
Minnesota?
I was born in Minneapolis. I grew up in a southwestern agricultural community of Windham, which you probably haven't heard of.
What's the crop of Windham?
Windham is a city of about 4,000 people, and it was known during World War II as the flax capital of the world.
Flax capital of the world. Now that's what they weave into rope and
that's
and
right.
Things
they,
like that.
Yeah, well, they made explosives out of it too.
Oh, you were part of the war effort there.
That's right.
Well, maybe Saddam Hussein has a little bit of your flax
who knows?
Over there now. Who knows? So, growing up there, when did you first become exposed to violin music?
My parents used to take us. I had a brother and sister, and on their anniversaries, we would all go to Minneapolis for a little weekend.
Uh-huh.
And we might go to a movie and go out to a nice restaurant. And there was a very famous restaurant at the time in the Radisson Hotel called, it was old downtown Radisson, called the Flame Room.
Okay.
And they had a floor show there three times a night. The lights would come down and these flames, these humongous sconces on the sides of this room would shoot these flames up. And 10 guys would come whirling around the room in tails with their violins, and they would do this floor show.
Uh-huh.
And on their anniversary, they came around my parents' table, and they were playing, I think, something like the Anniversary Waltz, which is a traditional anniversary song.
Yes.
And I looked up at these guys, and this one violinist was watching me, and he was kind of looking at me like this, and gave me a little wink or something. I was about 8 years old or something, and
uh-huh.
I looked
is
at him.
Is he serving time now? I'm only kidding.
And I said to myself, that's what I want to do.
Is play the violin.
Is play the violin.
Because it had such a tremendous impact on you.
Yeah, it had flair, and it just looked like something I...
But now, growing up in a rural community, one would think that you would tend more toward fiddle music rather than classical.
Well, fiddle music are riding on a tractor. My parents raised me with great music. They belonged at the time to this club called the Reader's Digest Music Club, and
I think we all did.
Yeah,
back then.
Right. We got all these great records, the classics and the Gershwin and Cole Porter and all that. So.
Oh, that's great. So, what was your formal training then? Did you take in elementary school?
Well, I started when I was about 10, and I graduated from high school. I went to a community college, or not community college, a state college in Minnesota, and then.
Uh-huh.
Eventually ended up in Arizona on a music scholarship. I graduated
at Arizona State University?
Right, Arizona State.
On a music scholarship.
Yeah. I was originally at U of A, but I came up here real fast.
Migrated north.
Right.
Well, very good. Well, then you can root for both teams
that's right.
when they play yeah. against each other. That's not bad. Well, how long have you been here then, here in the Valley?
I have been here since 1970.
Since 1970.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's see, it's 92, so that's about 22 years.
That's right.
It takes, I think, 30 to become a native.
Is that
so,
it?
Yeah,
well,
when you get your card.
I figured out the other day I've actually been here longer than I lived in Minnesota, so this is home.
Oh, I see.
This
so you're paying.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so we'll call you a native.
Who wants to go shovel snow?
Yeah. Now, you told me something interesting about this particular violin that I wanted you to share with the folks watching.
Right.
This means something very special to you.
Well, that's right. This happens to be my grandfather's instrument.
Uh-huh.
And he was a fiddler. And when he actually sold the instrument before I started playing. He sold it to a farmer down the road. And when I when I took up violin, he went and bought this instrument back and gave it to me, and I have
How about that? Well, I'm dying to hear you play something. Real quick, though, something that you've created, something that you came up with, an idea that you came up with is something like, people send novelty telegrams,
right.
So like singing telegrams
mm-hmm.
and stripograms and
mm-hmm.
things like that, but you invented the violinogram,
right.
Is that correct?
The violinogram. It's what
now, if I were to hire you, just tell me real
okay.
briefly, because we want to
okay.
hear you play. Just tell me real briefly.
You called me up, and you want to send me over to serenade your wife on her birthday,
or girlfriend.
Or girlfriend.
Or both.
Or both.
Oh.
What you get
I'm
is
pay for that
all,
later,
our, okay. all our messengers are very fine violinists.
Uh-huh.
I, of course, are the head violinist messenger, and I do most of the deliveries myself. I would come out dressed like this, full formal attire with my violin, of course.
Uh-huh.
It comes with a long stem rose.
Ooh, that's nice.
That I present to the recipient, along with a personal message from you wishing her, say, a happy birthday. Or
so this would be a very personal way for me to wish someone
a
happy Valentine's or happy anniversary,
happy
birthday,
that's
something
right.
like that. I'm sure you've probably caught people at some inopportune times, haven't you? Can you think of
It's happened. It's just, I had a situation one time where somebody wanted to surprise their wife and have me come in, and they were going to cater breakfast to her in bed.
Mm-hmm.
And I was over there at 6 o'clock in the morning with the caterers in the kitchen, and he leads me through the hallway down this, opens the bedroom door, and she's laying there sleeping. And he rings his little bell, and she looked up, and I'm at the foot of her bed like this, ready to play, I think, Oh, What a Beautiful Morning or something.
Uh-huh.
And she looked up, and she had an asthmatic attack. She had asthma, and it's funny to think about it now, but I mean at the time she just went crazy, and so she was so terrified
by the fact
she went into tears and
strange people in her bedroom.
Yeah,
it's probably probably ended up in divorce court somewhere.
Well, I was actually there was a happy ending to it.
Oh,
but
that's
anyway,
good.
He chased me out of the bedroom.
Well, what's your most popular song at these kind of like Valentine's Day?
Valentine's Day is my funny Valentine.
My funny Valentine. Yeah. Well, I tell you what, would you play that for us?
I would love
and I
to.
I think you know Van.
I know
you
that guy.
Play together.
Yes.
We're gonna let you cross over here in
okay.
front. And that's fine.
Get hung up here.
Yeah,
you've
got
all right?
plenty of cord.
Okay.
And we're going to let you demonstrate a little bit of what you do.
Okay.
And I'm going to move over here and get out of your way. Steve Vaughn, ladies and gentlemen, doing My Funny Valentine. Steve, just beautiful, just beautiful. Do you now, kind of splitting the line here between fiddle music and and violin music,
right.
is a Broadway shows. Do you like to do Broadway
Broadway
material?
Oh,
now
sure.
I can't help but think of The Fiddler on the Roof when
that's
I see
right.
you with that. Do you have maybe
that happens to be one of my theme songs?
Oh,
my
really?
Song,
well,
my signature
I wonder
song.
Why.
Yeah. The thing was, is when I first started out playing, I started out playing in a rooftop restaurant in town here.
Ah.
And I became known as the Fiddler on the Roof. So.
Well, maybe we can hear a little
sure.
bit.
Sure. Okay.
Some Broadway memories with Steve Vaughn here. right. Very nice. Very nice.
Thank you. Thank you.
You know, it was... I didn't interrupt here, did I?
No.
No, okay. I want to make sure you got all the way through that.
That was good.
My favorite Broadway show, I mean, just to die for. I haven't seen it yet, but I play the CD over and over and over again, is Michael Crawford in The Phantom of the Opera.
Mm, and, it is gorgeous. We just happened to. We just happened to. Yes,
oh,
yes.
This is my absolute favorite. Well, we've got plenty of time for this. So,
okay.
So
right.
Just wow me here.
All
this
right.
is, what are you going to do from Phantom?
Music of the Night.
Music of the Night, my favorite song. This is where the Phantom captures Christine and is trying to convince her to be his bride. Bravo, bravo,
thank
bravissimo.
You.
Well, that just leaves me with shivers up and down my spine. You know, I'm partial to that show also because there's an awful lot of magic in The Phantom
That's
of the
right.
Opera. They do a lot of magical mm-hmm. effects, and so I'm hoping. I have friends in Toronto that keep threatening if we ever come up there, they'll get, take us to the, see the Toronto
see
version. So I understand tickets are a little easier to get there than maybe New York, but... That's fabulous. You and Van play around town.
Mm-hmm.
I mean instruments.
right.
Not on your watch.
Yeah, we play around.
You play your instruments
yeah.
around town.
Yeah.
Tell us where can we come see you? Where can people come and enjoy what you do?
We perform Thursdays, Fridays, and Sundays afternoons at the Phoenician Resort for high tea from 3 to 5.
Tea. I see. They you have to have a bit of an accent
that's
for
right.
this.
it's the finest tea in the city.
It won the last 2 years best tea in
best
the
tea room. Right. I wasn't even aware there was a competition. Well, that's great.
Now Van is also there Monday through Wednesday.
And then you come in.
They call me Mr. T because I'm.
Oh, I see. He's the fiddler on the roof, and you're Mr. T. I think we got a whole new series here, folks.
I think it worked.
Well, we've got a few more minutes here, so. If you would please play us out with something, and we'll listen to you. And as we get close, we'll let you know here. But please favor us with something, one of your favorites. And the light. And you may want to set that down.
Oh, are we going to lose
that
the light?
About bit the big one there during the Phantom. There we go. All right. Here we go. Van Coriton and Steve Vaughn. I think your grandfather would be very, very proud. Oh. Thank you for being
Brad.
Here. And
pleased to be
I
here.
Know that Van was happy that you were here because it gave him a chance to showcase what he can do. But we're very pleased that you
thanks
were able
for
to
having
be here.
Me.
And we hope that you have a very successful year this year.
Thank you.
And we
you
want
too.
To tell all our friends out there that we'll be back again next week with another edition of the New Variety Arts. You and I have worked together before.
We have.
Like Variety Arts, magic, and mime, and all that kind of stuff. So we'll ask you to join us. next week on the New Variety Art Show, when we'll have another exciting and interesting guest. In the meantime, remember to support variety arts in your community. Take us on out, fellas.
Give us the rose. We'll go out with some elegance.
Oh, here. Okay. Here
what
we go.
Here?
Somewhere in Time.
Somewhere in Time. Oh, the theme from the movie.
Right.
All right.